Hey guys, this is Eddie the Magic Monk. Today we're going to talk about how to make a really cool email signature. As you can see, I have written an email here. And if you're emailing someone for the first time, you probably want to create a really good impression. And down the bottom here, your email signature can say a couple of things about you that people are interested in. And as you can see, this email signature is a bit boring. It doesn't have any colors. It doesn't give you any details about who you are. So if you want to create a really good first impression, compare this email to my awesome signature, which I'm going to show you how to create. And you can see that it makes quite a bit of difference if you have an email signature like this one, with a logo, with some interesting fonts, interesting colors. So today I'm going to show you step by step on how to create this email signature. Okay, so to do this you will need Microsoft Word. So let's open up Microsoft Word. Just a blank document. And the first thing we want is a table with two columns. So go ahead and go to Insert, Table, and choose the 2x1 table. Now what we want to do is rearrange the size of the columns so that the first column is 4 units, 4 centimeters wide. And the other column is 10 centimeters wide. So the first boundary occurs at 4 centimeters and the last vertical line occurs at 14 centimeters. If your ruler displays the measurements in inches or something like that, you can go to File, Options, Advanced, and go down to Show Measurements in Units Of, and change it to centimeters, because here in Australia we measure in centimeters. Now go down and resize the length of the columns, length of the rows, to 4 centimeters. So now the tables, the cells are 4 centimeters high, and this is pretty much how our signature will look. So as you can see, back in our signature, that is about the same size as our email signature. Okay, now the first thing we want is to insert our logo. And if you have your logo on a website or something like that, you can simply copy it from Internet Explorer. So I'll just show you how to copy an image from Internet Explorer or from Google Chrome. So for example, on let's just use Google. Okay, if there's a picture that you want to use, so for example, let's say we want the word G here to be our logo. All you got to do is press the Windows key and press S, and what you're going to do is highlight the G word, and then you can simply click copy to clipboard, and then you can go back to your Word document and paste it in to the first cell. So otherwise you can access the clip art. So go to In Clip Art, and what I used to find this logo is I typed in the word education. So type in education, press go, and then just click the top left picture here, choose insert, and you've inserted the picture. Notice how Word automatically resize my cell to fit the picture, but the cell is too big, so I'm gonna resize it back to a bit of a smaller picture so that my cell stays on 4x4. Okay, now notice how in our email, I'm just going to resize it. In our email, I have the right hand side to be black, and that is because one of the colors of my logo is black. So pretty much you just want to make sure that the right hand side has the same background color as one of the colors in your logo. So I'm just gonna make my right hand side, make my logo black, sorry, make my background color black by going into, so right click on the table, choose borders and shading, and then click on fill black and apply it to this cell only. And you can see that my cell on the right hand side is black. Now we don't really want the box on the left hand side, the border. So we're gonna highlight the whole table, and where on the top where it says bottom border, we're gonna change this to no border. So now we don't have any borders. Okay, now on the right hand side, as you notice, I have my name in bold. So press enter, type your name in, John Smith, or whatever your name is. And notice how my font is Verdana and it's size 10. So I'm gonna highlight this, change it to size 10, and bold it. And then you can see that I also have the word maths teacher, and that's in the Calibri font size 10. So I'm going to press enter and choose and type in maths teacher, and there is no bold for my maths teacher. John Smith should be in Verdana. I'm not sure what happened, so highlight that, choose Verdana size 10, maths teacher is Calibri size 10, and now we're gonna press enter twice, and notice how I have reduced the font to, oh, it's still size 10. So I'm just going to type in School of Awesomeness. Make it one of these colors on my logo. And you can see that the color on my logo is pink. And it'll be pretty hard for you to get the exact color by going into font color and more colors. It's hard for you to pick the exact color from here. So what I do is I did a little trick. I copied my logo into Paint. So I open up Microsoft Paint and pasted the picture in, and I use the eyedropper tool. So if you click on this tool here, click the color, you can see that it's automatically selected the color here. And if you go to edit colors, you will see the information about that color. So red is 255, green is 63, blue is 63. So if you go back to Microsoft Word, if you can highlight the School of Awesomeness and go to the font color, font color, and change, so go to more colors and then go to custom and change the number here to 255 6363 like it told us in Microsoft Paint, and now we have that color, same color as the logo appearing. So that's what you need to do to copy the same color into your logo. And now we're just going to use white again, just making sure we're on white. Hang on a second, font color white. And we just want to type in the same information as we had in the email. So I'm just going to type in all the address and things like that. Now notice how I use the divider, a straight line here. That is achieved by pressing the shift key and then the backward slash key, which will give you that. So it's the same key as this, but if you press the shift key and then press that, you should get that sign. Press space and just type in the address, type in the phone number. Keep in mind I made this number up, so I hope no one has this number in Brisbane. And then type in your email. Notice how as soon as you type in your email, Word automatically changes the color to dark blue. So what you want to do is highlight that, go to font color, make it white, and that should reset it back to white. And then the last thing you want is type in your web address for your company. And then what you want to do is on the right hand side there's a bit of space, maybe put another logo there. So I'm just going to put in insert clip art and put in one of these logos. Make it a bit smaller. And also make the wrap text in front of text so that it doesn't obstruct your text. So just make it a really small one on the bottom right hand side. Now if for some reason you have more information that you wanted to insert, you can also make these words a little bit smaller so you can highlight them and make them 8 or something like that. Then you can insert more words down the bottom. So what you want to do now is copy this signature into Outlook. In Microsoft Outlook, if you click on New Email, and you go to Signature, and go to Signatures, you'll notice that we had our original signature here. So we're going to delete that. Yes, we're going to delete this boring signature. And we're going to go to New, and we're going to type in cool signature. And all we're going to do is copy and paste our signature from our Word document. So just select everything, copy, and paste it into our signature window. And new messages, we wanted to use our cool signature, and reply messages, we want to use our cool signature. So click OK. And then what will happen from now is every time you're in Microsoft Outlook and you click new email, this signature will automatically pop up and you can type above it. And also when you reply to somebody's email, so let's say I want to reply to this email, this signature will also pop up. Okay, thanks for watching the tutorial. Hope this tutorial was useful for you to create a cool email signature, and see you next time.